She's on the dress.
If you go. So firstly, I just really like to thank Peter for being our MC. And we've all heard the story of Peter introducing Dave and I. And I think it's a very brave thing to set a person up, or two people up, because it can go terribly wrong. So it's a very brave thing for Peter to do. And Peter is also brave because she was the only person crazy enough to agree to go kayaking around Antarctica with me. And everyone said we were crazy. And we didn't think we were. We thought it was a perfectly normal thing to do until we got there. And the first time we accidentally smashed into an iceberg, we realised it was a little bit crazy. And we had quite a few near-death experiences, which is probably being honest, and Mum, you haven't heard of all of them, so sorry. And probably the scariest was involved people shouting out off the back of the ship, "Don't worry, girls, we'll tell your parents you love them." And I have to admit, I think we genuinely both thought we were a bit done for. But I couldn't have asked for a better person to be sitting in the little orange kayak with me. So before I go any further, we need to do a toast for Peter. Getting in a taxi with Dave. Setting us up and getting in a kayak with me who can't really kayak. I'd really like to thank John and Sandy, because you have always been so open and warm in welcoming me in your family. And Teddy, the first time he went to the town's house, he peed on the middle of their dining room. and he's been invited back since. So, and I think Ash, Beck, Melissa, Peter, the extended town family, you've always been so nice. And I think it shows why family is so important today. You can see where that comes from. So thank you very much. And you can have 50% of my... 50% of me, John, it's okay. to Luke, who flew all the way back from LA yesterday morning, thank you for coming back, and Morag as well. I think you said it, you've known Dave since you were 6 months old. I think it was more critical that you were here today than I was here today. Seriously? That's pretty cool. So thank you very much for coming back. It means the world to Dave and I. And Tom, thank you for two things. From me, for Dave coming today with both of his eyebrows, and I think we're wrong last Sunday night. And on behalf of everyone in the room, I know you had to do a lot of the shopping around with Dave, so thank you for choosing sensible suits and probably not the tartan crazy ones. To this side of the room. So part of the reason that I didn't really want a wedding and wanted to elope was because before Mum and Dad's wedding, some really bad things happened that I was really scared. Sorry. That I was going to jinx it tonight, so I was really nervous. So it means the world that you are all here, and I know there's a lot of people that aren't here. But thank you so much for coming. Sarah and I are really lucky to have you all as family. So thank you very much for coming. Mum, you are super tough. For anyone who doesn't know, Mum did all of the flowers here today and outside. She's worried they don't look good, but I think they look awesome. Mum, you've had a lot of really tough things from when you were young and a lot of great losses, and I think my resilience comes from your resilience, so thank you very much. I think you do everything for Sarah, Dave, Teddy and I. seriously, I think Dave, Teddy and I, you know, wouldn't function without Mum. She wraps his necks. He has necks every day and Mum wraps them. from when I used to work as a lawyer, and some nights just so I could have a meal at home rather than at my desk, Mum would run out to the taxi with a doggy bag of food to give it to me just so I could eat a meal at home and not at my desk. So Mum goes above and beyond for all of us, and she always puts everyone else first. So thank you very much. Don't cry. Dad, hold on. Dad, That is the sensible one. Say
that again.
Everyone thought it was hard for Dad because he grew up in a house full of girls, but actually he had access to so many beauty products and moisturizers. Bathroom than anyone else in our family, still to this day, to get ready. The reason we were late getting in the water taxi was Dad loves to but I think Dad has always backed both Sarah and I on everything we wanted to do for whatever crazy job, scholarship, whatever it was we wanted to apply for. You've always told us to go after anything. You've told us to stand up for ourselves, but pick our battles. Which I try and do, and even now at work, if I have like weird, complicated situations, Dad and I have hypothetically, Dad, if you know this was going on, because I can't tell what it is, what would you do? So thank you for everything you've done for Sarah and I. Neither of us would be where we are today without you guys. Well, has always been like the big sister. I'm sorry, this Polaroid picture because I'm taller. It's possibly the last picture that was taken when I was taller than Sarah. Sarah has always looked out for me and gone above and beyond, and I wouldn't want to mess with her day, so be careful. Speak to me about the moments when she cracks it. But I think it's fair to say that Sarah and I, we have great times, we get mad at each other, but she's still my best friend, and she has my back at any time, so thank you. Steve, I think we should all give you a round of applause for officially being the tallest bridesmaid in history. for anyone who doesn't know, I know Steve since we were kids. We used to play tennis against each other. We were from different clubs, and we used to play against each other in these district championships. And I used to lose to Steve in the final like twice a year, every year. I tried playing with all different people. It didn't work. And it took a really long time for me to figure it out. And I think when I was about 17, I decided to play with Steve instead of against Steve. And it was a really good decision. If you notice how tall he is, it's like one step, he's on the other side. But we've done lots of travel together, and I think you know, we're very true to each other in terms of calling each other out, and Steve's a great friend. So thank you for standing up front. And then lucky last is Dave. and it sounds so terrible when Robin said it that you're really, really nice, but you are. You are just really, really nice. No, and it sounds so bad because nice just doesn't feel like it's enough. but you are. And I think, you know, how much you look after Teddy and I and what you do, and you make me laugh all the time. Like, it doesn't matter how crap a day I'm having or how good a day I'm having, Dave will make me laugh. And he's so genuine and gets along with everyone. And I think we are going to have a fabulous time together. So thank you for choosing me and Teddy. And I promise to try and share the love more. But he's adorable. I say it all the time. When I look at him, it makes me hurt a little. And, you know, when I look at you, it makes me smile. So it doesn't hurt, but I smile. So my toast is to great husbands, family, and friends. Yeah.
I would just first say thank you so much for everyone coming along tonight. It means the world. And I would definitely in particular like to thank Lynn and Steve and Kessis and Sarah for just being so welcoming to their family. I think like the first time I went, and went to their home, I just felt so almost a part of their family already. They were really, really welcoming and just really lovely people deep down, and I knew that from the get go. So, and I see where that comes from in Kate. Beautiful. Still, family has a big influence. I'd like to thank Mum and Dad and Beck. I think that I judge my morals on them, and they set a really good example. So thank you very much for that. Very good. So I just feel there's a lot of love in the room tonight, and that's just a beautiful, beautiful thing. My wife, she's just.
Aww. Aww. She's not big.
Yeah. I was waiting for that. When I first met Kate, and still now, I thought that she was totally out of my league. And as I got to know her better, I found out that was more than just a imbalance in our appearances. I also found out that it was just whenever she does something for another person, which she does all the time, it's not just a curse, it's a thought out, considerate act that she's doing on her part every single time. And that's just, yeah, something. I don't have the words for that. I just thinking about today, I was just staggered at how lucky I am. Particularly, of course, the time when I met Kate, she'd just recently been introduced to the love of her life. A small ginger thing. For some reason, was entrusted with our rings today. I'm stoked that she's willing to. To share. I want Lynn and Steve and Sarah to know that I will do my best to be a good husband to Kate all the time. And I'm not just motivated by my love, but also by the fact that that the space I occupy in our home and the with my belongings and myself, she'd be quite easily filled with more shoes and clothes. The fact that she's decided to put me in that space is a great sacrifice. I'll be forever grateful. But yeah, finally, I think that I just can't think of another person I'd rather spend my life with. And I think that if I have a full life with her, maybe I can learn to be half as good hearted as she is. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Hey.
Hey.
Thank you very much.
Let everybody know that is actually.
Okay, cool. I understand now. Okay, so that's actually the end of the formalities. And I was going to rhyme the end, but I kind of worked out you're probably tired of rhymes by now, so I don't think I'll do that. So this is the end of the actual formalities, and the last time I'll get up and speak. A very big congratulations to Kate and Dave. I have a very, very small role to play. You guys did all the work, and you are a beautiful couple, which is obvious by what everyone here sees today. So, congratulations. So, dessert will be served. If you see the waiters coming to try to kick you off your seats, in particular this side of the room, gasp, shock and horror, you will be making way for the fantastic dance floor. So consider it it's an honour. It's an absolute honour and a privilege. So this is definitely not the end of the night. It is only the start. You're expected to boogie the night away with the rest of us. So congratulations, enjoy dessert, and I can't wait to have my dance.